Electric vehicles, those that use electric motors instead of gasoline engines, have become very popular. Those who strive to protect the environment and go green love electric vehicles. But many would be surprised to learn that the EV isn't a new invention. While history is uncertain about who actually created the very first EV, what is certain is that there were electric motors in use as far back as the early 1800s and before the invention of internal combustion engines. One known electric motor was created in 1828 by Ágnes Jedlik, a Hungarian inventor. He made a small model car that could move on its own via a small electric motor. It is said that the first electric vehicle was displayed at an industry conference in 1835 by a British inventor by the name of Robert Anderson. Robert Anderson's vehicle used a disposable battery powered by crude oil to turn the wheels. Anderson was not alone in his pursuit of electric mobility. Around the same period, Thomas Davenport, an American blacksmith turned inventor, and Dutch professor Sebrandis Straeting both invented model electric vehicles. However, all were little more than prototypes of electrified carts, traveling at top speeds of 12 kilometers per hour with cumbersome steering and little range. Then in the 1860s, a French physicist by the name of Gaston Plante invented the first rechargeable lead-acid battery, a huge breakthrough for electric mobility. But another Brit, Thomas Parker, is credited for the first production electric car in 1884, just about a couple of years ahead of Carl Benz and his petrol-powered Motorwagen. The Americans weren't far behind. William Morrison, an American chemist from Iowa, made a six-seater electric vehicle, capable of 23 kmph. By 1900, electric cars were so popular that New York City had a fleet of electric taxis, and electric cars accounted for a third of all vehicles on the road. Many rich people began swapping in their horses and carts for motorized vehicles. As a result, the automobile rapidly grew in popularity and the battle for the future of mobility commenced. The options? Steam, electric, or gasoline. More people liked electric because in many ways early electric cars outperformed their gas and steam competitors. Electric cars didn't have the smell, noise, or vibration found in steam or gasoline cars. They were easier to operate, lacked a manual crank to start, and didn't require the same difficult-to-change gear system as gas cars. Steam vehicles required startup times up to 45 minutes and continuously needed to be refilled with water, limiting their range. As more people gained access to electricity in the 1910s, it became easier to charge electric cars, adding to their popularity with all walks of life. Many innovators at the time took note of the electric vehicle's high demand, exploring ways to improve the technology. For example, Ferdinand Porsche, founder of the sports car company by the same name, developed an electric car called the P1 in 1898. Around the same time, he created the world's first hybrid electric car, a vehicle that is powered by electricity and a gas engine. Thomas Edison, one of the world's most prolific inventors, thought electric vehicles were the superior technology and worked to build a better electric vehicle battery. Even Henry Ford, who was friends with Edison, partnered with Edison to explore options for a low-cost electric car in 1914. The production of electric cars peaked in 1912. Fritzschel, for example, built about 198 vehicles per year between 1909 and 1914. However, this momentum would all come to a slow end. When Henry Ford introduced the mass-produced and gas-powered Model T in 1908, It symbolized a death blow to the electric car. By 1912, a gasoline car cost only $650, while the average electric roadster sold for $1,750. In 1912, Charles Kettering invented the first electric automobile starter, effectively eliminating the hand crank. Kettering's invention made the gas-powered auto even more attractive to the same drivers who had preferred electric cars. The discovery of Texas crude oil also reduced the price of gasoline, making both car ownership and car maintenance more affordable to the average consumer. By 1935, electric cars had all but disappeared from the road. It wasn't until the early 70s when the gasoline car hit its first real roadblock. Oil shortage, dependencies on a few countries for it, and of course, its rising prices. Automakers, feeling this social shift, started to explore options for alternative fuel vehicles, including electric cars. For instance, General Motors developed a prototype for an urban EV. The American Motor Company produced electric delivery jeeps that the United States Postal Service used in a 1975 test program, and even NASA helped raise the profile when their electric lunar rover became the first manned vehicle on the moon. Yet, the vehicles developed and produced in the 1970s still suffered from drawbacks compared to gasoline-powered cars. Electric vehicles during this time had limited performance, usually topping at speeds of 45 miles per hour, and their typical range was limited to 40 miles before needing to be recharged. Automotive companies modified popular models to create electric variations, hoping they could improve the batteries and achieve a range and speed closer to that of gasoline-powered vehicles. One of the most significant turning points was the introduction of the Toyota Prius. Released in Japan in 1997, the Prius became the world's first mass-produced hybrid electric vehicle. In 2000, the Prius was released worldwide, and it became an instant success with celebrities, helping to raise the profile of the car. To make the Prius a reality, Toyota used a nickel metal hydride battery. Since then, rising gasoline prices and growing concern about carbon pollution have helped make the Prius the best-selling hybrid worldwide during that decade. However, the real turning point would come in 2003, when two entrepreneurs by the names of Martin Eberhard and Mark Tarpening saw an opportunity. After seeing the growth of lithium-ion battery capacity in their previous venture, Eberhard and Mark formed Tesla Motors in 2003. Fast forward to 2006, and the Silicon Valley startup had announced it would start producing a luxury electric sports car that could go more than 320 kilometers on a single charge. Tesla's subsequent success spurred many big automakers to accelerate work on their own electric vehicles. The first commercially available plug-in hybrid, the Chevy Volt, has a gasoline engine that supplements its electric drive once the battery is depleted, allowing consumers to drive on electric for most trips and gasoline to extend the vehicle's range. Nissan raised the competition with its launch of the Nissan Leaf in 2010, simply ditching the hybrid powertrain and offering a purely battery-operated electric vehicle. This zero-emission car became an all-time hit, top-selling EV. Over the next few years, other automakers all over the world began rolling out electric vehicles. Yet, consumers were still faced with one of the early problems of the electric vehicle: where to charge their vehicles on the go. In the US, the Energy Department invested more than $115 million to help build a nationwide charging infrastructure, installing more than 18,000 residential, commercial and public chargers across the country. That boosted EV sales of companies like Tesla. Tesla is the most valuable automotive company on the planet, worth an estimated $1 trillion. All major car companies in the world moved towards electric car manufacturing. The growth in electric mobility, and especially passenger electric vehicles, has been profound. The amount of EVs on the road has exploded, from negligible in 2010, to approximately 1 million in 2015, and by the end of 2021, there were as many as 12 million electric cars on the world's roads. This growth doesn't seem to be slowing down anytime soon. As governments, companies, and individuals look towards a sustainable future, many are turning to EVs as an integral step in their decarbonization journey. There you have it, the surprisingly interesting history of the electric car. There's just one thing that we can't stop wondering about. What would electric cars be like today if the Ford Model T hadn't been so successful? Just imagine what battery technology would be like now if development hadn't stopped all those years ago.